Hello, everybody. Welcome back. There are so many more dudes to shoot. So many more, and so very little time. How many dudes do you think I could shoot in the next hour and, 12 minutes? Like 100? 200?
As long as you just don't stop reloading. Man.
That's right. All right, well, let's do it.
I want the opposite of that. There's going to be a pretty fucking horrific roar from Arcee as she does indeed slam her shoulder into one of those four poster bed posts to pop back in. And there's a scream of pain and hold. And I want to get it at the point where these dudes are battered, they're beaten, they're fucking, you know, things are like they're gonna keep going until they're dead.
See, but I'm doing the exact opposite of that. Like, as the dudes are falling on the two guys, I'm behind with my gun, just being like, "What? What? Yeah, that's what you get. Yeah, hit him again. Come up in my house. Fuck you.
Fuck you. Yep."
So, Sean, because they are
savage,
you are gonna have to actually command them to stop. They do not want to. They want blood. They want to murder these guys.
Yep. And I'm happy to take a devil's bargain that this will piss them off too. I'm happy to make this be something that, like,
sure,
they're going to resent not getting this kill. But what I want,
start a new clock.
Okay.
Call it challenge Arcee's command.
Yeah.
With four pieces. and fill one of them in. So yeah. when that fills up, someone's gonna make a bid to
bid.
Arcee, dude, you gotta let tigers be tigers, man. You can't take away their claws.
Fuck up, Tanner. Nice.
I'm not even listening. I'm just shouting at these dudes. Yeah. I'm the guy at the like edge of the ring throwing money and being like, yeah, blood.
Yeah, you're part of the problem. But
let's actually I want to ask this question from my prerogative as GM here. Arcee is when she turns it on, she is a very intimidating, very, very intimidating leader.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. I'm scared of her like fucking crazy.
So when she really puts it on and you're there with the group, does her command role affect Cantor too?
So the thing about Cantor is that he responds to his own fear by pretending it doesn't exist and overcompensating. Right. So when you scare Cantor, he's like a fucking blowfish. He just gets bigger, but it's all nothing. He's hollow. He's full of air. Right. Yeah. So he's just like, if you're like, you intimidate him even a little and he's going to be like, what, fuck you. And like, get up in your face and like respond totally inappropriately instead of just being like, yeah, no, you're right.
Yeah.
Right. So is it possible for Arcee to actually shut you down?
Not in that way. No, not by yelling at me.
Okay. So right. Then I grab your face and slam you into the wall. Actually, I just come up behind you and choke you out. And then I yell at the guys to make Cantor an example.
You want to resist the choke out, Cantor? You want to just eat it?
I mean, I got to resist, right? I can't let these dudes see me get fucking headlocked out.
Right, because you're not shutting up, and I need that shutting up to happen. So
yeah, right. And we're gonna have a conversation with this later because you're making me look like a chump. So
yeah.
You're acting like a chump.
Yeah.
No, don't make it worse for yourself, Sean. Sean,
please make sure I'm present.
Well, you're totally. I mean, you're
so you're outside the power structure, okay. Oscar.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cool. Yeah. Okay, Cantor. This could be resolve. It could be prowess. It's up to you how you're actually resisting here. Are you just like too much of a pain in the ass to go out, or do you actually physically like fight her off?
Yeah, I'm trying to get away. Like, I'm trying to get out for sure.
Okay. Yeah. You can use your prowess. Yeah.
Okay. There's that six.
Dude, man, you're taking risks. writing checks your body can't cash.
It's true.
So yeah, zero stress. You actually you get a hold of Cantor, but he sort of wrestles you know back to a stalemate where you're kind of like on equal footing.
I probably don't even know it's you. I'm probably just like shouting at the dudes like, get this motherfucker off me.
Yeah, right.
You're right there. Like, you don't have to give up if you don't want to. If you want to push it, Darcy, you can like actually attack him, but you don't have the drop on him anymore. He like,
well, my concern is not taking out Cantor. My concern is being able to talk over him to the people. So if that is sufficient to like distract him from yelling, yeah, fucking kill him, then that's fine.
Yeah, Adam, does Cantor like back up and like do the whole like, okay, oh, you want to go? Like, is it back?
I'm trying to fight you now. I'm not saying anything to them. Okay. I'm like, but I am like, I mean, I'm shouting at them to help me because I think I'm being attacked by another person I just didn't see before.
Right.
Okay. So at the very least, it like diverts Cantor away from what he was doing.
And I think that that's made this more difficult because now it's showing that there's some division. I didn't have this like iron grip over Cantor that I wanted. It feels like that is putting me in a more precarious. It's like the anti-help. Like, well, right. Because we're working at odds, like my goal has always been to stop these guys. And further, I don't even want to stop my guys. I want to intimidate the shit out of the two dudes being clubbed to death so that they'll listen to me. So
is your major goal here like stop the fighting and just like have everyone's attention and like stalemate the situation?
Yeah. I want to send these two fuckers home with a message, and I can't do that if they're dead.
Gotcha.
So yeah, I need everyone to hold.
Okay. I think you have a position to. I mean, you can at least do that to your own guys for sure. And
yeah, where I think it gets desperate is that I'm trying to basically also. I'm going to shoot for desperate role in that I'm trying to cow the Sashes as well. Unless you feel like that's easy because they're getting the shit kicked out of them. I don't want them to do some crazy gymnastics, leap the fuck out of here the moment the dude's not pummeling.
Right. Yeah. I think if you just stop the fighting, like their choices would be to try to cut their way through all these dudes or to stop fighting.
Yeah.
Like they can't really escape from where they are right now. And if they if they started to cut in, then the fighting would start up again. So
that's cool. Cool. So call it.
Yeah. I don't think it's actually that desperate. They're in a bad spot, so.
No problem.
I mean, if you want it to be so bad that they like lay their swords down and surrender to you, then that would be really pushing your luck there. But if it's just like, hold on, stop.
Well, I may be trying to roll two things into one, but I want them to go back to Malera with a message from us, and I want them to like honor that. And that maybe
step one is to stop the fighting, though. I think
that's cool.
Yeah.
All right, I'm doing it.
Yep. So this is you're actually in a dominant position to do this. So
awesome. Nice.
And you have your extra die.
I took my extra die, and yet I still only rolled 5.
Got a 5.
I'm a terrible player.
So you do it, but there's a consequence, of course.
Of course.
Yeah.
I'm gonna say it takes extra time. You have to just really like they don't just immediately stop. You have to keep talking and keep yelling and maybe even like grab the rearmost dude and pull him back or whatever you gotta do. And in the extra time it takes, one of the gang members gets basically mortally wounded. They get like a really bad thrust through the torso.
Yeah.
And one of the Red Sashes gets his leg broken by a belaying pin from one of the dudes and like hobbles backwards and props himself up against the wall, and the gang member is lying there gasping and bleeding to death on the floor. And then everybody stops. And you've like fought your way to the middle of the pack and like face now, and everything's stopped.
Awesome. Yeah, so there's obviously that, like, that persistent, you know, she shouts a few more times just to make sure that we're all clear that we're listening to Arcee now. We're using our listening voices, you know, we're hands in the air, ears open, assholes. Then she turns to the, she pushes to the front and goes to the Red Sashes and grabs one of them with her, like, not dislocated arm. Grabs the guy with the broken leg just because he's even fucking more vulnerable.
And yeah, like he kind of like brandishes his sword at his side when you do that. He doesn't threaten you with it. He just like grips it and sort of, yeah. He's kind of like, and you pull him.
Yeah, I say, you're going to be using that as a fucking cane. That's assuming we let you live. You're going to go home now and you're going to tell Malera that this is our home now. This is the Six Towers gang. And if she wants, yeah, the Six Towers.
What am I doing while this is happening? Like, where am I? Because you kind of like choked me and like threw me aside, I guess.
Yeah, I don't think I've like done anything. You okay?
I got a point to prove to you, not this guy. So I want to walk up beside Arcee, and just fucking shoot this guy and be like, fucking conversation's over.
I want to resist that.
Yeah, yeah, totally. If you want to, like, get in my way or whatever. But, like, yeah, I'm, like, I'm all pissed and, like, all red-faced when you're choking me. Yeah. And acting like a petulant child. So I just, yeah, I'm going to walk over and be, like, I'm not going to say anything. I'm going to do what I did before and just, like, walk up and try and just shoot him and then tell you why I did it.
Yeah. So, Arcee, you see, you hear the footstep, and then you see one of the Red Sashes, like, trying to make a decision. Like, you've seen it before in men's eyes on the Leviathan ships. Like, he is thinking, I got to do something right now to not die, and it's probably going to get me killed.
God, I love those situations. I better do something to avoid the thing that's going to happen anyway.
You just see that pass across his face, and his sword is like, starting to move. And
I'm gonna
what's
step
probably going to happen is he's going to lunge past you at canter.
Yeah, I'm going to step in front of him so that I'm in between him and Cantor. So Cantor, you shooting him is going to be shooting through Arcee.
Well, I'm going to shoot the guy on the ground, not the other guy. Like the guy, so there's two guys, right? And the guy that was going to kill me, and there's the guy that was like holding a sword.
The guy with the broken leg, Arcee's like holding him by the front of his
That's
robe.
The guy I want to kill.
Right, right. That's so, the guy I'm holding right now.
Yeah, I know. But then and it was the other guy that was like, I might
the other
do
guy
something?
Is just,
oh, the other guy's doing nothing?
He's there with his sword. He's ready to go. He's ready to fight.
Okay.
So, either way, you have to step past Arcee, but if you attack the one she's holding, I mean, it doesn't actually matter that much because it's a really small space. Yeah. You're going to have to get past Arcee if you want to do this. And Sean, you're saying that wherever Cantor goes, you're just going to interpose your bodies.
Yes.
And
I want to resist this with resolve, and you get the choice of, do you want to shoot Arcee? Because she's not fucking having any more dudes getting killed right now.
That's a dumb attitude, Arcee. You are bad at crime.
Sweet. Okay, Sean, go for it. Resolve it up.
Yeah.
I mean, is that fair, Adam? Do you feel like that's a fair problem for you to face?
Yeah, I mean, I want to be able to like do the thing. So if you fail, like, I don't want it to be like you have to shoot me or you don't do anything, because those are both doing nothing. So.
Right. Well. When you roll a resist, the thing doesn't happen and you take stress. There isn't a option of the thing might happen or you take stress.
Right. So the reason I mentioned that, Adam, is like, if you want to, you could roll an action to try to do this so that Arcee can't block you.
I just feel like I'm faster than Arcee is the thing. It's like Arcee's all distracted and I'm just like,
I agree.
Nope.
Yeah. Yeah, but you've also pulled this shit multiple times on me and I've fucking had enough of it. Like, you did it to the bouncer too.
Yeah, totally.
I would say,
and it's worked out great so far.
Let's say that you can do it as an action. On a six, you can just do it. You're just too clean.
Yeah.
Sure.
And there's no choice to make, but on a five or less, like, Arcee is going to interfere and
That sounds good.
You know what I mean?
That's totally fine.
Okay. Yeah,
that makes sense to me.
I like it.
So there's no position here exactly. It's just a roll. You're gonna roll your skirmish and.
All right.
You can push if you want.
I don't have a lot of stress to throw around, so
yeah. I don't have a devil's bargain here, really.
It's okay.
Oh well, actually, I do actually.
Okay, hold on. I ignore that. You can't undo a roll once you start it. I want to hear your bargain before I actually roll.
However this goes, Cyclops is gonna come after you.
After who?
You, Cantor.
I'm on his side, man.
Yeah,
God
but
damn it, Cyclops.
He knows what RC wants, and you're messing with it.
It's fine. I'd rather fight him than RC because I can actually kill him and not feel bad about it.
It's true.
All right, I'll do it. I'll take it.
All right.
No, Cyclops.
Fuck so, Cyclops. Yeah, he's the worst. Wolverine forever.
Oh man, there it is.
All right, so much for my resistance roll. I had that all queued up.
Okay. Sorry, Sean.
Too fast for
no,
you.
I can't seem to ever get that like leg up.
I mean, it is actually special. Like reflexes are reflexes, and
yeah,
you see what's happening. You make your plan, and you're thinking about stepping between him right. when
and
he
pulls like the boom.
He's just really fast. It's like fuck, fuck,
yeah. Fuck. He did it again.
So. The red sash, the other one, so he blasts the dude with the broken leg down to the floor.
No, he blasts the other guy, right?
Oh,
I'm holding the guy with the broken leg.
It was the other guy? Okay, sorry.
I think so. I don't know. Adam, what?
Well, I wanted to shoot the guy you were talking to because, like, originally I had wanted to, like, prove a point, to be like, you're doing this wrong. Why are you talking to this guy? Like, we need to kill these dudes and be done with it. But... the way that the fiction, it makes more sense for me to just like shoot the other guy, but I can be looking at you when I do it. I can just be
I get
sure.
it.
Sure. Okay. Yeah.
Rather than having to like climb over you and shoot the guy.
Yeah. Right.
You blast him.
Hold on, RC. Just slip, push, go. Yeah. Like just put the gun over your shoulder. Yeah.
I shoot upstairs. It bounces off the chandelier and hits him. No.
Yeah. All right.
He goes down. He doesn't instantly die. He has a gunshot wound that smashed through his clavicle, and he's holding his neck and bleeding and choking on the floor, and he will die from that. As will your dude who's been stabbed through the heart.
Yeah.
Or the lung, I guess, really. and the guy flinches in your grasp and blood spatters his face.
Yeah. I assume mine as well.
Sorry?
I assume mine as well.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
We're pretty close.
You're right there. When that happens, he goes for a killing stroke on you, Sean.
Yeah.
This was clearly some kind of trick.
Yeah.
This isn't a conversation. This was like you let their guard down and your ally just blasted his friend. And
right.
Down.
Well, what he perceives as my ally. RC's not feeling like
we're
that.
We're on the same side. We just
doesn't matter.
Got different approaches.
Oh, you're on Cantor's side.
You're holding him, and he like.
I thought you were too.
He what?
He does. He like twists under. You're like holding him like this, and he twists under your arm.
Yeah.
So he comes up right in your face.
Yeah.
Hand behind the neck, and you feel him like going to do the like full sword up through the solar plexus.
He's got a broken leg.
Yeah.
He's known as the broken leg. I want to fucking drop down and drive my elbow into his knee because we're just like super close up.
Yeah, right you're right there,
and basically just bring him to the ground in agony because I'm
incapacitate him with the yeah. Okay.
So, resistance.
I love how both of you are making these like wrestling moves.
Well, we're that close. There's not like you can't duke it out, right? There isn't a lot of you know, I had him like literally in
No, it's not that. It's the fact that you and John out of character are making
Oh yeah. Okay.
No, I
get him in a figure four and then
This is like a mutual fight. He doesn't have the advantage, and you don't yet either. So you're gonna like do an action.
Skirmish. Okay.
Yeah, you're gonna roll skirmish. I think it's difficult. It's like equal footing here. He's going for his finishing move, and you're going for yours.
Yeah.
So the people's elbow is coming down. Yeah.
You're counting frames to that.
Oh, people's elbow are
a three.
Not well.
That goes badly for you. So Cantor, what you see is you walk up and you're like, I don't know what you said. Was it like conversation over, bitch? Boom.
Yeah.
You blast the guy. You look back and RC's, well, we'll see. You get to resist this horrible attack, RC, because you're a PC. But what would be happening is this guy's like sliding his sword out of RC's, points coming out of her back. So it's going to be, it's only difficult. So sorry, it's not deadly harm. Sorry, I take that back.
Yeah.
This is just incapacitating harm. So it's like not through your solar plexus or something. It's like through your, like under your floating rib. You kind of twist sideways and he jabs you through. So
yeah, nice.
You'll take level 2 harm impaled.
Yeah, impaled is good.
Or you can resist that if you want, or you can just take the harm.
No.
You're going to take it?
RC, may I make a suggestion?
Sure.
This is when you say, so John, as you might know, RC usually wears at least light armor.
That is totally possible. You may be wearing light armor, yes.
Yeah.
Sorry, well, I run this game a lot.
No, that's good. Yeah, we haven't ever really talked about armor in this game yet.
So. Yeah, that's true. It is. I mean, I'm not going to wave my character sheet in front of the screen because you can't see it anyway. But it is checked.
Perfect. All right.
And we were going on a hit. So
yeah.
I kind of like the impaled, but I like Cantor having some consequences for fucking shit up. But I don't think he considers his teammates.
We were winning this fight until you got in my way.
I had
RC.
No, this is awesome. This is awesome. Good role playing, folks.
Yeah, I'm into it.
Bad priming, but good role.
Yeah.
No, it's good. He doesn't have. Well, let's see. Actually, let's think about this. He's tier 2.
I don't have fine armor.
Yeah, which means his weapon is at least one tier better than you.
Mm-hmm.
I think you should get to knock it down to a flesh wound instead of impaled. But it should still count. You do have armor, so
yeah.
He tries to get you the light armor under your shirt, twists the blade sideways, and he like slices off a hunk of flesh, bloody wound on your side.
Nice.
Bloody wound, level 1 harm, which is just, it's just really messy, but it doesn't last long. And then he's gonna keep going, because, I mean, he thinks he's just being killed here, so you guys are gonna keep fighting unless someone else intervenes. The gang isn't going to intervene. They're just like, yeah, get him, Marcy.
Yeah. I have to fucking, every time I try to like put the fucking law down and have any sense of order in this place and not just be savage barbarians, it gets challenged by, if not Cantor, then this asshole.
Yeah. Yeah.
So he's going to, he's gonna try and take off. As he gets like a couple steps, I'm gonna grab him by the back of his.
No, sorry, Sean. He's not trying to leave. You wrestle down to the ground, and he's dropped his sword. He's trying to go for his knife.
Oh! He's not trying to pull. Oh, fine.
No.
That's great.
Yeah. He thinks this is a fight to the death now, so he's just.
Perfect.
Yeah.
I'm gonna get on top of him and just fucking just start punching him until his face is never gonna be pretty again. Yes. Now I'm channeling Fight Club.
Okay.
Kill him.
But again, he's not gonna die.
Kill him.
Nice. Yeah.
Devil's bargain. You mash his nose up into his brain. He dies.
But I will take, because my intent is that he lives, I will be happy to take Devil's bargain that he fucking hates my ass forever. Because if he is significant enough to be matter. I'm happy to send him home with that he'll deliver a message, but he'll have a personal that I will make.
Yeah, I think you're already kind of getting there.
Yeah, with the face.
But he might get his knife out. If you want a devil's bargain, like, yeah, he can stab me, but I'm going to punch his face in. I devil's bargain that.
Sure.
Okay, cool. I mean, it makes you look even more badass in front of the group, right? He pulls a knife out and you're like, I don't care. Bam, 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 bam.
Yeah.
Nerd.
Yeah.
Whatever.
Stab! Bam, 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 bam. Loud. Toss over shoulder.
Yeah, exactly.
Right. Well, at some point after you stab me, you know, you can do the damage. I want to, like, just slap it out of his hand and keep punching him, but I'm totally happy to take it.
Okay, cool.
See if the dice can not be so shitty for me. See how these go. There you go.
Boom.
That's how we do.
All right, yeah. Now you take your level 2 harm, which is stabbed.
Yep.
So his first move, he like sort of parries you off to the side, gets his guard up around you to control your hips, and then his dagger's out and like flashes into your chest real fast, like chunk, and this like pumping chest wound spreads through your shirt. But to his surprise, you're punching him in the face when he does that instead of blocking him.
Yeah.
So it cracks his head against the floor and he goes a little dazed, and then you just keep pummeling him until he goes limp on the ground.
Yeah.
And that the gang around actually like cheers. They're like, "Rah!" And they kind of push forward and grab the dude and drag him off and throw him on a bed and tie him up and stuff.
Yeah.
How badly injured is this guy?
The guy Arcee just fought?
Yeah.
He has a concussion and a smashed patella, and
is there a chance he's just gonna bleed out anyway? Or is he like
he could tight? Potentially die from his wounds, but it would be like his leg could get infected or something. He doesn't have an actual
okay. Wound.
No.
Yeah.
With a little bit of doctor care, he'll survive, but there's a chance he'd die from this.
So I feel like we need to like just cut to us talking about this afterwards, unless we're gonna do like immediate shit right now to deal with the fact that all these crows are coming. Like, if we're gonna address the crows, we need to do that in the moment. But otherwise, I feel like
Yeah.
I know that Dr. Creepazoid has things to do.
But I have been waiting to deal with my whisper. All
right. Right.
Oh,
you're right. I'm sorry.
All right, Spoopy, do your thing.
No, please do it.
I will deal with the bodies in a second, but rewind time. Back when you were still grabbing people with sashes and pulling them out before the argument and everything happened.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, I'm trying in the to weird find... zone.
Yeah, John, I've got crazy astral sight up. I'm sorting through the ghost realm, and I am looking for where the fuck is all of the commands and the ghost magics and everything coming through. Now, I've been like blocking and fighting, so I have some clues. Do I need to roll? Can I find this out? I'm going to take my time because they're dealing with the rest of the shit.
Yeah, we got shit on our mind.
Yes, you have to roll because he is going to try to do something in that interval. You'll find out where they are, but we're going to see if you can beat them to the punch and do your thing before they do their thing.
All right.
So
tell me what I got to roll.
It's difficult. You are attuning to find them, I assume.
I am fine with this plan.
Okay. I mean, you could just like visually try to do it, but attuning.
So if the question is, do you do something weird and creepy in order to find something out, or do you do it visually? The answer is I do something weird and creepy.
Totally. Yeah. And you're already like, we've established that you're connected to each other's power. So you're kind of like feeling back to the source of that power, right?
That's right. I'm counter hacking this asshole.
You're so creepy. Why are you such a creep? God. Gross.
I think it's the name of my class. It's like Wiz Creepster.
Yeah, full on Creeperama.
Full on.
Creep on the Borderlands. Like, you're just the weirdest dude anyone knows. I'm proud of you.
I will give you a devil's bargain. A devil's bargain is you don't keep perfect track of Silver and what she's doing while you do this.
No, fuck that noise. Goddamn stress.
Start threat challenging things we care about. That's
so. Means- I think I take like My hand is still steaming, so I think I just grab some of the blood from that and I wipe it across my mask. And for a split second, nothing happens. And then you hear a cracking noise as like the stone starts opening. And I'm just scanning the ether. Where the hell is this asshole?
All right. Silver like watches you in the ghost realm there to see like if you lose focus, and you don't. So she just kind of hangs. She just sort of stands there.
Like, okay.
Roll it up. 5. All right. You do it. But there's a consequence.
I think I see a 6.
Oh, what?
Oh, no. Never mind. That was the roll before me. Carry on.
Yep.
All right. Okay, so... I'll stop you with my rolls.
Just leaving your dice lying all over the place.
Ooh. You end up in a desperate position. That's interesting.
I think you'd have to go out on the roof. You'd have to go up there physically to, like, even though it's all mystic sight and shit, you still be line of sight to some degree. You gotta have to fucking mano a mano with this whisper with, like, none of us around to help you.
I like that. That's good. Yeah. Yeah, so we cut to you, like, precariously, like, placing a foot out on the tin roof, and then on a rooftop across the way, like, sitting in the lotus position. This hooded figure in the dark.
Creep on a hot tin roof.
Yeah, exactly. The hood like slightly turns to face you as you try to get your footing. They are you can feel their power. They're the susurrus of their whisper is going through the air, and
I love that we actually hear each other power as whispers, which is why we're called that.
Yeah. You hear the words like coming past you. I mean, you're beating him to the punch here, so this isn't really happening yet, but he's calling out to command the ghosts of the slain Red Sashes to flee and like draw themselves away from the scene, off to do whatever. But you get to the rooftop as he's, you know, incanting those words, or just starting to do that. What do you do from your desperate position?
I'm debating. I have two motions here. I could intimidate the shit out of him, or I could just fry him.
Or you could just leap off this. You could make a running jump and leap off this tin roof and just try to, like, tackle him onto the ground.
No, screw that noise. That's not me. I've got like zero skirmish.
I know.
Oscar's not a fighter.
That's why.
Yeah, Oscar's not a lover either. He's just
not a lover. Not a fighter.
I'm not a lover or a fighter. Yeah, that's how that phrase goes.
Right. So I think I'm debating because I have this plan. I could totally just like put my mark on him and like seal him up for the moment and be like, no, I'm the bigger whisper, get the fuck off my turf.
But you're outside on a tin roof where there's like lightning possibly.
I'll take the desperate because that puts me at 6.
That's what Cantor would want you to do. Protect your turf.
This is so hard. I'm leveling up.
Well, you're desperate. You're in a desperate situation no matter what. So you're
all right. Yeah, that's totally happening. I think I'm going to pull a trick that maybe this guy doesn't know. So I think I hear the susurrus of his whispers, right? Yeah. And this is what I'm doing. I pull out my vial of demon's blood, right? And I take it and I actually crack it so that there's like the jagged like glass and it starts igniting. And I run my hand over it so that it's cut. And what I bleed out isn't blood, but it's that black substance that goes into the tattoo ink. And where it hits the roof, it starts forming patterns into like a ritual. And like I'm squeezing it out, almost like I'm pushing it out of my hand. And then I take the demon's blood and I whip it into this like ritual form. And as I do, I call out Satara's name and I whisper across the oceans to her. And I'm just like, oh yeah. And so this shadow hand will reach out and brand my fucking mark onto his spiritual self. And I'll be like, get the fuck out of my town. You ain't doing this. No more whisper shit for you.
I like how you're like in the anime version of this game. No, right. Like, the rest of us are like, yeah, no, it's like The Wire. And you're like, yeah, but like, what if?
What if The Wire was like, sweet? And none of you guys don't see.
We don't see or like none of this is happening. It's like cutting back and forth between the, it's like someone with ADD is just like flipping back and forth between the channels, being like
totally. Well, okay, so you know when Jesse is like strung out and we just see him all like bloodshot and freaked out, but we don't actually know what's going on in his head other than he's pissed off. This is let's see what's going on in his head. Fuck you, fire.
Oh my god. Yeah, Jesse's version of Breaking Bad is like Scott Pilgrim.
Yeah, that's almost exactly what this is. All right, so yeah, so...
All right, well, once again, Strauss, you're very good at this. Here's my devil's bargain. Intone Satara's power for a bonus die. You already did that. Okay, great. Cool. So you've got that going for you.
Yeah, you got that going.
I am trying to earn her favor. I have a clock for it.
I know. And you should fill in a piece for doing this.
I totally do.
Oh, Lord. This is bad. Okay.
Bad? Are you kidding? It's awesome.
I mean, bad is relative.
Both. Use the power's power. What's the downside?
Four.
Well, four is at least not a three.
That is true. That is
better
true.
On a desperate gamble.
Wait, Strauss, why were you rolling three dice? Do you only have two attune? Really? Oh, wow. Okay.
Well, you can only start with a two. I mean, that's...
I just thought...
Like how defensive, like a defensive you were about that, Sean. Like, hey, come on. You wrote this game. That's not fair.
I know. Exactly. Like, two is pretty good.
I always assume Strauss is like more leveled up than everybody else. So yeah. Okay. Four on a desperate. My favorite roll outcome in the game.
Full Metal Scurlock over here.
Yeah, exactly. Desperate with a consequence and as many as a want. Wow. Okay. But you do it. So your goal here is. Brand this dude with your creepy whisper mark thing and drive them out of Duskwall.
I think it was just from here, right?
I was okay with gang turf, but you know.
Oh, you were just going for gang turf. Okay. So I'm going to push up the effect with Satara as much as you're pushing for. And so if it's just the turf, then her power will manifest that much. If it's the city, her power will manifest that much. So,
turf is fine.
Okay. All right. So, is it like a warding? Like he may not return, or else face Satara's power.
Yeah, that's exactly what it is.
Okay. Okay. It's not just leave for now. It's like you're actually keeping him out.
Yeah, basically what I'm saying is like, bro, you thought you were coming after some scrubby gang, but get the fuck out of my house.
Get wrecked and stay wrecked. Thank you.
Okay.
Because I think this is important, right? Like, this is the first time we're actually facing a real gang. Like, we're not rolling three people in a basement that don't know what's going on. Right. And this is the story they will tell about us. It's like the Sashes sent their hit squad and they sent, like, a badass whisper. And we were just like, no. And the whisper will live to tell that tale.
Yeah. That's great. What happens to you, though, is what I'm pondering here. So, start a new clock. this is the first part of the consequence. What should we call it? Let me tell you what it does, and we can come up with a name for it. So, you feel this power well in you. And it comes very easily in this moment of desperation. You're like, Satara, attend me. And she does. And you feel the dark sea far out beyond the electro barrier and something waiting in the black water.
We just see the water and then like bubbles coming up.
I was gonna say it's like Evil Dead. We get the like high speed camera like across the water, like
totally. Yeah. And it just for the audience's benefit, it flies past the docks where there's this ancient structure, this half submerged grotto that's clearly like thousands of years old in the foundations of the city. And it twists through the grotto down beneath the water into the dark. And there are these pod type things.
Oh, yeah.
These like stony orb, bullet shaped kind of orbs floating in the water, all bound with chains. And floating in the midst of them, curled up, is this black scaled creature. And its shark eyes snap open and
dank grottos.
Yeah, the dankest of grottos. So you take a tick on Satara's favor, which I already said, I think. Then you start a new clock. So let's figure out what to call this. Satara is Lord Skurlock's demon. Imagine a tug of war clock between you and Lord Skurlock. And let's just give that a name. I don't know how you want to track it, but
Satara's will, Satara's
I know what you call it. It's
demon pact.
Yeah, demon pact. Yes, it's not. Its favor is she likes you and is interested in you as a person. Pact is the actual binding of that demon is shifting over. So let's call it eight pieces, I guess, probably. That seems about right. Skurlock is not a four-piece binder, more of an eight-piece. but go ahead and fill one in. So somewhere, again, like...
I do not resist this effect.
Okay, cool. So somewhere we see like the angle shot of this beautiful chair with a fireplace with no fire in this house appointed with ancient art, antiques and stuff, and a hand holding a goblet of dark fluid,
with
pale bony fingers, and it's raising the goblet up out of view to drink, and then stops and places it back down again, and there's this ominous kind of like, wait a minute.
Toccata and fugue starts to play.
Someone's messing with my shit. So that's the first consequence. In addition, this whisper, you drive them out. You see them like hurled backwards across the rooftop, and they stumble and then sort of get carried away, kind of like they were doing with the Tempest. You like force them backwards. But as you do that, they're not just some pushover that can be easily sent away. That whisper of commanding the ghosts coalesces around you, and this cacophonous, like, crashing sound smashes through your eardrums, and they try to just, like, hit you on the way out.
Nope.
Once again, resisting with resolve. Can you do it? Three in a row. Let's see. So this is going to be severe harm. They're going to, like, smash your eardrums, give you a concussion, drop you like a marionette. Hey, two stress. Okay, so let's reduce that to level two.
You can take two level two wounds, right?
Okay. Yeah, you can take two. Let's call that I guess concussion is pretty accurate. Your head, you get your bell rung, basically your head's ringing, and it's like you just got ate an uppercut to the jaw.
I'm just gonna say rung, level two.
Nice. So yeah, so your feet slide on the tin roof, and you're shaken, and when you look back, like, there, the whisper's gone, their power subsides, the ghosts don't rise from the bodies here, and they're driven off. Hooray!
Hooray.
Nice.
I'm really enjoying that we can have this like other game that Strash and I are playing.
Yeah, no, it's weird and awesome.
The weird game. we're all fans.
Because you know, I mean, because you know that as soon as the fight's over, Cantor's gonna be to Oscar like, "What the fuck were you doing the whole time, man? Where were you? We were fighting these guys."
Yeah.
He'd be like, "I was doing stuff." Yeah.
Let's take care of shit.
See any of that?
We love this show. We just have no ability to interact with it at all.
I think if Oscar is like slowly climbing down, right? And if Cantor's like, "Where the shit were you?" You hear the like the slurping noise as like the little legs like remove themselves and like kind of crack as like I take my mask off and I offer it to you. Like, you want to see?
It's like blood's coming out of your ears.
Yeah. Oh yeah, yeah. There's like actual like holes where it like punches through, and I'm just standing there with it like dripping.
Such a creep.
Creep. All right, so we have several dead bodies here whose ghosts haven't been,
and one possessed guy.
Yeah. And we all know what happens next. Like, we all know that a bunch of crows all fly off in about the same proximity, and we're gonna have blue coats here, we're gonna have spirit wardens here. We have to deal with at least four deaths: the bouncer from last session, the guy that just got shot, the guy that Cantor shot on the roof, the other guy Cantor shot in random.
Yeah, I think there were six total in the Whisper, and two of them weren't killed. So yeah, there's four.
So I mean, the question I have here though is that, like, yeah, the Spirit Wardens will show up and stuff. We're not in like a fancy part of town or anything, and these guys are just gutter trash, right? So like, if we're just not around, they'll just come and pick them up and fuck off, right?
I have control of that ghost still, right?
Yeah. Yeah. Hang on, Strauss. To answer your question, Adam, that's very likely.
Right.
It's possible that being a tier two organization, the Red Sashes have
some sway with the cops. And
they might have some sway with the cops, but standard procedure would be, you know, take the bodies and yeah.
Sure.
So actually what I was thinking is, we know where Red Sash Turf is, right? Like, that's the place where we're supposed to go.
You're in it right
now. I was just going to command the ghost and basically be like, pick up the legs of your compatriots and drag them all over there. Go.
Oh, the possessed guy. Have him take the bodies and fuck off. Yeah, you can do that. Yeah, totally.
Make it their problem. They came at us. They can clean up the mess.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know where their headquarters are. It's like south near the canals. He can load him into a wheelbarrow.
With like a totally blank face, just walking through the street, dragging two bodies by the feet. Like, it's going to be awesome.
It's a victimless crime.
Yeah. That will take a little bit. Like, one of the gang members goes and gets a wheelbarrow and brings it back and whatever, and you can load them up. And
the same one we brought the barrel in the first time before we got the set up.
That's my wheelbarrow, man.
That's right.
That's my delivery wagon.
No.
Well, it's going to deliver a message to the doors of the Red Sashes.
Actually, you guys have a boathouse now. You don't need that anymore.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
That's why I'm saying we can send it out.
Yeah, you can totally do that. He'll.
Is that cool? Do I need to roll?
No. You've commanded him. That's all good. Yeah.
All right.
And it's not like the crows are like instant homing crows. They take a day or so to kind of settle in, or you know, they'll get into the neighborhood, and the spirit wardens will come and kind of look around. But in an hour or so, you can deal with the bodies this way. So I think you're good.
Nice.
Normally there would be some peril in like taking a wheelbarrow load full of bodies to the Red Sash's base, but you're not doing it, so it's not your problem.
It's some Red Sashes who's possessed by some other Red Sash. Ghost.
They obviously killed themselves. Yeah. A ghost did it. We just blame the ghost. Bouncer,
yeah.
Just blame the ghost. Problem solved.
Nice. So I want a thing to happen with this dude who's all broken, and I really had a very specific message I wanted to send back to Malera. That's not just we're badass.
Do you want to do this and then like load him on the wheelbarrow with everybody else?
Sure. So he's like the one conscious one.
Yeah.
Give him some smelling salts or whatever. Wake him up.
Yeah, you have time before that happens.
So. Right. So, but I need to make sure that I can have. So I'm Cantor. I want to have a conversation with this fool when he wakes up, but I need to make sure I can have a conversation with him without you just walking up and shooting him in the head.
Fucking fight's over now, isn't it?
Good. turn away. And I'm gonna wake the guy up. Once, you know, stop around.
Yeah, so like the gang has, they're all amped up. They're kind of around. They're with RC. Like, you guys are getting this really strong vibe that it's like RC's gang, basically.
Well, yeah, because I'm gonna take these fuckers out, and we're gonna go party after this.
Yeah,
like there's gonna be some drinking and some more fighting after this.
So like Cyclops is like sticking right close to you. They're kind of like crowded around.
That's and fine. So
you slap this guy back to consciousness, and he's like all his face is swollen up now, and
yeah,
his sinuses are clogged with blood, and his teeth are loose, and he's like, fuck, you know. What do you say?
So I put my hand on his throat and I get close enough to his ear that he can feel the warmth of my breath when I whisper into his ear. And I tell him, it's not so people can't hear, it's so that he does not possibly miss this. But I tell him, all of your men are dead. Except for one who's possessed and is going to carry your asses back. Everything you came with, we fucking cut down. You come again. No, not you. You tell Malara that if she comes again, we're going to cut her down even harder, and we're not going to take it lightly. Or she has a choice. She's already fighting a war with the Lampblacks, and now we've occupied this territory, and we're not a threat to her. So she can either have a nice safe zone between her and the Lampblacks right here, or she could be a fucking idiot and fight a war on two fronts that she's going to lose. And that's the message I'm sending him back with. That
nice.
She should not maintain any hostilities, because if she does, she's going to get fucked.
Nice.
Do I need to command him to convey this, or no?
Nope. Yeah. Cool.
Are you kidding? That scared the pants off of me.
You can tell by the look in his eyes that he is definitely gonna tell her everything. You know, his demeanor, it's hard to tell with his smashed face, actually, but his demeanor is not like, that's a good point. I'll totally tell her that. He's just like, you can tell he's like, yeah, I'm gonna tell her that, and then you're gonna fucking pay. Like that's his mindset.
Yeah, absolutely. That's
so if you want to, you could command him to try to like really terrify the dude, but he's definitely gonna give the message, and he's pissed and like wants to tell her because he hopes that she'll, you know, order them.
He hopes that she'll react in the way that I just told her not to react.
Exactly. Yeah.
Hmm.
Yeah, I want this dude to like live in terror of us. I want this guy to be like
your read on him is that he's
not easily broken.
Sorry?
I was just saying not easily broken.
Not that you couldn't do it, but like he's defeated, his team has been killed, and he wants payback. Like he's acting the way you would in this situation.
Yeah.
He's like, oh no, fuck you, like no one messes with us that way.
So you know
if you want to terrify him, you can like up the ante here and really give it to him. But you just haven't done that yet. He's just...
No, I could start taking fingers off and shit, but that's fine. Because him being pissed off right now is exactly where I would be. But he's helpless to do anything about it. And he's just going to spew all that rage at her, and she's going to hear the message. So that's fine.
Yeah.
I don't need to tear this dude down anymore to get what I want.
Cool. Yeah, and he's basically helpless, and that's a really shitty part for him too. At when you like load him onto the pile of bodies of his friends, and he like can't really move at all, and he just like settles down into their corpses, and he's just like,
I feel like, cause I watched this whole like exchange, and I just want to be like to the dude, I just want to be like, sorry man, winds of change. This is how the shit goes. You are out. We are in. He's got to roll with it, man.
In a different circumstance, Cantor and this guy would be on the same page,
right? Totally.
But in the moment, right here, he's not like, yeah, like
no, no, and that's the thing is, I'm not trying to convince him. I'm just kind of like, come on, dude, like, Yep. Yeah, sorry about your face. That's how it goes.
They underestimated you, they tangled with the wrong people, and they got fucked.
Yeah, right? No hard feelings. Like,
yep.
That's how it goes. Yep. Sorry about your face.
And this is the thing with this game. Like, you guys are tier zero and tier one now. In the world of the crime world, you're nobodies, but your characters are really dangerous.
Yeah.
So when these bigger tier guys like try to fuck with you, they get their nose bloodied real hard. And
yeah, you know, they didn't.
You're lower tier, like,
they didn't exactly come with the kid gloves on though. We got I believe we are stabbed, cut. Concussion. What's the other consequence? You got Strush, the burn hand, you know.
Sure.
I have two. I have rung bell and burnt hand, which is also the name of my first hit single.
That's right, the burned hand.
They, from their point of view, they sent their kill team, and their kill team got sent back in a wheelbarrow.
Yeah.
Special forces my ass.
If they do want to mess with you, they're going to have to bring everybody. Yeah.
Blasted hand, my bad.
Awesome. Yeah, so he gets wheelbarrowed back with his dead team and his possessed guy. the gang is like super amped, and fortunately you've already thrown your weight around. Like, their savagery has died down. They're not wanting to go out and continue, which they might otherwise do. But they're like, fuck yeah, God, yeah. They're like super hyped. And left to their own devices, they're gonna just party and drink and.
Well, there's one thing that they've gotta do, which is they gotta pick up their own. Because one of ours died.
Yeah.
And we're not gonna send them off on a wheelbarrow. We're not gonna do anything real fucking gracious. We're just gonna drag them off so the spirit wardens find him. But we gotta.
Just gonna dump him in the canal or something?
Do we know? Is this guy anybody?
Because
I think I want to throw him off the docks into the water. Feel like that's where a sailor wants to go.
Sure. Yeah.
I mean, we're next to the docks anyway. This isn't a long haul, but like, if we don't know him, if he doesn't have family, if there's nobody that's like, if he's got family, we take him back to the family and be like, sorry, here's money.
Somebody raises their hand and says that he was from Acheros, I think. They served with him on a hunter ship.
Yeah.
They know his nickname. Is this like Fight Club? We should give him a name now.
Yeah, the dead guy's got a name.
Yeah, his nickname was Breaker.
Nice.
And he's got tattoos from all four corners of the world, and he's a veteran sailor that gave up the Leviathan hunting for an easy life.
Yeah,
as a criminal industrial
life, it went easy. I mean, cool. Yeah, so we take Breaker out. We have some drinks. We throw him off a dock, and then we continue to party at the docks. Continue to drink and probably do some more fighting, but of the friendly variety.
Yep, there's plenty to be had all along the wharfs here.
Yeah, and RC isn't particularly stopping yet. Tomorrow morning, she'll really regret this, but she's not like. You know, she's had her shoulder dislocated, she's been stabbed, she's been gashed, and she's not like, you know, she's gonna like wrap it up, but she's not gonna like stop until tomorrow.
Yeah, nice. That may, next time we play, that might roll into vice recovery and stuff, because Marlene's around and, you know, all that, so. Sure.
Right.
We'll see.
I'm resolute, I'm good at recovering.
That's right.
Well, it's good to see at least that RC understands the process of these things, like after a big fight, it's time for shots. So
yeah, exactly. Like, Cantor, do you go with RC and the gang and party, or do you?
Totally, yeah. Like, we just fucking won a big fight. Like, I have forgotten literally all of the tension between RC and I as soon as the fight's over. I'm just like, woo, we won, fucking sweet, let's go.
So the question is it now the time to bring the PvP? Because when you come, RC turns is like, no. Go fucking count your coin.
Oh, shit.
I'm taking my boys out. You're clearly not my boys.
Let me just color this up a little bit. Yeah. Cantor's going, and like one of the gang, this like this wiry sailor, he's got like this shaggy mohawk, he kind of like jostles Cantor, like, yeah, like that. And then when Arcee's like, no, he kind of looks confused for a second, and then he actually like pushes Cantor away. And the gang gets really bristly for a second.
Yeah.
And it's not super hostile, it's just like mom and dad are fighting, you know, it's like, oh, what?
Yep.
Yeah, so I think I look at you and I'm like, the fuck's your problem?
The fuck's my problem is you don't know how to listen.
Yeah,
because you shut the fuck up. You don't know when to put your goddamn gun down. You bring heat we don't fucking need.
I'm gonna go ahead and point right out now. How many of these motherfuckers I put down while you were getting your ass choked out.
Those motherfuckers, if we want to kill motherfuckers in the Red Sashes, the motherfucker we want to kill is Malera Clev. The more of her men we kill, it's just the more that we piss her off. Now, I might have bought us a little bit of time by telling her that coming back is going to hurt. But I might have also just pissed her off so that next time she comes, she brings twice as many men, she does it while we're sleeping, and we're all fucking dead. We did not need to kill a single motherfucking person here. That bouncer, if we beat him down and sent him off, he would have talked about us. He would have talked about the Six Towers game. But you had to fucking shoot him in the head so that stupid fucking money changer would know our names. You fucking have no goddamn brain, and you're going to get us all killed. Now, we're alive right now, and we're going to celebrate that life, but you are not fucking part of the solution. You're part of the fucking problem, Cantor.
Like, the way I remember it, the only reason your dumb ass is alive is because of me. And this isn't a boat, girl. You're not the captain of shit up in here. These are the streets, and this is how it works out here.
Go fuck off. I'm going to go party with my boys. You can go drink anywhere you fucking want.
I'm going to look at the rest of the gang like, you want to fucking hang out with this pussy? Like, she didn't kill anybody, and we spilled blood. I'm appealing to their savage nature to be like, and I'm very much pointing out, like, she didn't kill anybody. Like, what a fucking wimp.
Right. She's also sporting all kinds of wounds.
Yeah. I didn't get touched, and you look like shit.
Yeah. I think looking like shit is what's appealing to these guys.
Yeah, but there's a difference between getting your ass kicked and getting in a fight, right? Like, you didn't kill anybody at all. So, I think that's, like, I'm making that point. I'm just kind of like, you know how it works. Like, you can give orders, but, like, I'm the guy with the gun, right?
Yeah.
Totally. And I think we don't know quite yet how monolithic the love, or not love, the like, abeyance of Arcee is. Like, it seems monolithic, but Cantor's just like driving a wedge right now.
Yeah, right.
So if it makes, I mean, it's kind of up for us to discuss as a group here. I think you are in position to make a command roll, Adam, to like,
it's command. It's the opposite, right? Like, I'm trying to unleash them. I'm trying to be like, you don't need her telling you what to do. Like, you're already doing the right thing. You are a bunch of bloodthirsty motherfuckers. That's
like sway.
That's totally sway. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's sway. You're. For sure. Yeah. Cool. So this is going to be a fortune roll. We're going to see how much. So how fragmented are they? Is Cantor able to have a big impact on the group and like peel off a bunch or half of them or something? Or is he going to have a little impact or whatever?
And like, is this something I can resist? Because, I mean, we're obviously having this argument back and forth.
In this case, we could do it as opposed. Like, he rolls his sway, you roll command, I guess, probably.
Yeah.
And it's, you know, who are you tied? Does one of you beat the other by a lot? Is it neck and neck? It's that. Yeah. Kind of
thing. I'm playing the wrong game. I'm rolling off against Adam. That's a terrible idea.
And my goal here isn't to like seize control. It's like
No. Yeah.
Like I just wanna cause what they were doing was right. Like I wanna spill blood and cause chaos and like fucking burn this mother down.
Right.
So I wanna remind them, you don't need somebody like leashing you. You wanna like bite people's throats out and like get crazy up in here. I'm the Lil Jon in this situation. I want them to turn down for nothing.
Absolutely.
And so yeah, I'm just trying to like make it get real.
Arcee's saying, no, you're not allowed to do that with us. And you're like, really? And we'll see if some of them are like, Cantor's cool.
Cantor's fun.
Hey, let's not rule that out.
Yeah, totally. Cantor's good with a gun.
I'm like the fun, irresponsible, like, do whatever you want. It's going to fucking rule. Like,
right. Yes. Yeah, totally. And I'm the domineering. No, we fucking play by rules.
Yeah.
All right.
I do think my prerogative as GM here, Adam, unless you think this is bullshit, I kind of want to give RC a bonus die because, like, these guys are sailors. They're like disposed to follow her orders.
I guess. I feel like the inverse, though, is that they're not sailors anymore. They're not on a boat. They've given that life up, and she's trying to put them back in a box, right? She's trying to put the fucking chains on.
That's a good point.
No, you're not on the boat anymore. Like, you left that life so you could do whatever the fuck you want, and who needs a captain?
My counter, though, is that I'm rewarding them right now.
You're not going to pay for their drinks, right? Like, they got to go out. Like, you're honoring them with your presence, but, like, you're a nobody, right? You just get your ass kicked.
No, I'm rewarding. I mean, I perceive this as I'm leading my posse out. We're going to go have a good time. And the only thing I've said is not they can't do anything. We're going to go drink. We're going to go fight. We're going to have fun. It's you're not welcome. Like that's my.
But the implication though.
I don't think anyone has the upper hand yet. I think we're finding out where they fall on the spectrum.
Sure, totally. Yeah. I'm just trying to undermine the like structural stuff, right? Because I'm like, yeah. No. Because in a way, the real argument I'm saying to RC is like, you're not the boss of me because you're not the boss of fucking anybody, man. Yeah, we are all equals in this gang, and you can't boss me around. You can't boss them around. I'm just using them as leverage to be like, yeah guys, she can't boss you around, which is really just Cantor being like, fuck you. You can't boss me around, but I'm not willing to like step up directly to you.
Well, this is the moment too, because in my mind, and I think Sean too, like we are going in this mode of like, well, these guys were sailors and they're gonna step two, and we're gonna get them back into this mode. And Cantor's like, no, none of that. We're not doing that. Yeah.
So this is the crazy space we were just in. We're staying there.
Yeah. You gotta keep riding the bloody wave, or they're gonna lose their edge, right? Yeah.
Totally fair to say no. These guys are not sailors, because if they were sailors, they'd be out on a boat.
That's exactly what I'm saying. Yeah.
It's an open question. Yeah. What type of dudes these are? And yeah, that's great. Let's find out.
So for the sanctity of roll 20, why don't we roll one at a time? So there's the or I guess our dice are different color, right?
Yeah, they're different color. Okay. Yeah. Okay, so can I how many dice do you have? Three?
I'm rolling three.
Okay,
I'm gonna throw stress into it because this is big deal for RC.
Yeah, I will too.
Yeah, I thought so. I thought so. Yeah. Oscar.
Yes.
Are you involved or not?
I think that there's this moment, like Oscar is standing there like real quiet to the point where this fight has just sucked away all of the attention, and he's quietly binding up his blasted hand.
Yeah.
And he's kind of watching this, but like if the gang starts splitting, there's gonna be that horrifying ghostly voice. I'm just waiting to see how this. I say it. Fuck it. I'm sorry, Adam. I love you, man. But I think there's this moment where Oscar, like everyone's forgotten he's there, and then all of a sudden he's talking, and like the Whisper never talks to the gang really, unless it's like, where are the bodies?
Right. Yeah.
So
There's this
moment where Oscar just looks up, and he's speaking entirely too old for his age.
Yeah.
And what he says is, Cantor, RC has been devoured by a leviathan, swam to shore, and I was there when she walked out of the ink black sea. I shake my head and I say, you don't want to pick this fight today.
Just like, put my hands up, I'm like, I don't see any fucking leviathans around here, but if you bitches, and I look at the, like, gang, I'm like, want to hang out with somebody who just got their fucking ass whooped, and a little fucking kid, you do whatever the fuck you want, but I'm gonna go get real.
Well, RC will not forget your help, Oscar, but, so positioning-wise, does that mean I'm rolling it's not gonna really affect anything dice-wise, right? I don't
So
help doesn't add dice.
No, it doesn't. This is a weird case, but there will be an effect.
Cool.
I think it's going to be more of a scale issue. So two-thirds of the gang is on Arcee's side. So when the two-thirds of the crew is on Arcee's side, and the gang is going to fissure along those lines. So the ones that care about Oscar's opinion, which are not very many of them, but exactly. there are some. So I'm gonna add that into the effect realm, if that makes sense.
Yep.
Okay, let's roll them up. And these aren't opposed exactly. This is how much sway or command you have.
Yeah.
You can both have a lot and just split the group or whatever.
Yeah. No, that totally makes sense. I mean, I think we both have very compelling.
Totally. Well, it's an important moment for the development of the gang too, because it's like I'm telling them like not to change, and you're trying to keep them under control.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, you're telling them to change.
No, I'm not. I'm. Well, they've already changed, right? Like they're off the boat, and I'm saying like the things you're already doing, like you wanted to kill these guys just as bad as I did. Don't pretend like you're civilized like her, right?
Yeah.
Don't go right back under command again. Like
yeah, right? Exactly. Like you just got your freedom from that shit. So
yep. I love it.
Cool.
All right.
Two roll dice. You ready?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Who's going first?
Let's do it. We just both.
You go first.
You go first. All right. All right. Okay, I got five.
It's not gonna matter. It's smoking on either end, but
Adam did not get a six. Behold that shit.
Oh my god.
I have five.
All right.
All right, Sean, you haven't added six all night.
It doesn't mean on four dice I can't still roll a three.
It's true. There's a six. That was close without that six.
Oh god, they got
lucky you went with the extra die.
Good work. I know, no shit.
Awesome.
All that ones and twos and shit.
All right, so you both have like you really hit them. And they really have to think about this, and they really are affected. But Arcee is like the better communicator, probably in this situation. Like she's just kind of, yeah, she's kind of more compelling, and then Oscar kind of undercuts Cantor's idea a little bit when Cantor's like, oh, she's all beat up, and Oscar's like, hey, you know, she came back
I'm
from...
I'm actually trying to remind them of how she eats knives and doesn't care.
Exactly, right, yeah.
But nobody... Yeah, and that's sort of the human thing is, like, I think that it's like, yeah, taking... Like, to Cantor, taking a punch is a fucking thing anybody can do. Anybody can get their ass beat. Like, great. I got beat up a ton of times. Killing a man, that's how you show you're tough.
Yeah, right.
Which
right,
is like totally crazy, and the inverse is totally true. Like deciding when not to kill someone is way more of a big deal. But
yeah, but it's close. So
the guy that I saved, right? The guy that was getting like dragged away, that I like
shot. Yeah, the guy was like getting choked.
Is he one of the guys that goes with Arcee?
I mean, that would make sense that he'd be one of the dudes that went with you, no? But like,
well, no, but I want to see, like...
I mean, he was coming with me, for sure, but that before this all happened.
No, he isn't going to go with Arcee. Okay. He has this, like, swollen bruise around his neck, and he knows you saved his life.
I guess that's something that Kendra would be aware of. Like the dudes that decide to go with me, are they the dudes that like put like sword to flesh, or like where do we draw the line here? Is it the people that didn't kill anybody that go with Arcee, and I get all the bloodthirsty crazies, or what? Like how does it divide?
Kind of like you both have a big impact with your words, and Arcee just edges you out. So it's a fissure.
I mean, only one of them killed anybody, which is Cyclops. Cyclops killed one dude. Other than that, you killed everybody, Kendra.
Oh, that's true, actually.
None of them actually, like, dealt killing.
Hey now! I got one possessed. I spiked one.
No, but... Oh, that's true.
Oh, that's true. Yeah, you did ice spike.
Right. Yeah. So I'm just saying, of the gang, only Cyclops killed anybody. The rest of them just beat up dudes and shoved them in the corner.
I feel like, Adam, it's a split, like, the more grizzled veterans go with Arcee, and the younger guys, the guys that left the seas younger.
Sure, yeah, that makes sense.
They reconsider and they're like, yeah, Cantor's cool. Like, why would you? They don't say this, but they're like, we're not gonna ostracize Cantor. Cantor's a badass, you know.
Yeah. Look at them all playing with guns. Yeah.
And unless you relent, I don't think either of you relent.
Oh, fuck no. So, well, it's exactly like what we were talking about before, in that, like, there's ways to defuse Cantor, but getting up in his face is the opposite of the way to do it, and that's what you're doing. So I'm doubling down when I shouldn't.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah.
Right. And normally when you do that, RC backs off. But right now she's been stabbed.
Exactly.
She's been fucked up. She just doesn't want to have any of your shit. She just wants to see your ugly face. You know, she's like
there's,
I'm gonna enjoy myself.
I think that Cantor had some, like, in some distant part of his brain recognizes that, like, making, like, taking these bloodthirsty maniacs and pushing them to more bloodthirsty could maybe turn out bad. But at this point, it's just like, no, fuck you, Arcee, don't argue with me. Shut up. Let's go. Come on. You know, it's like, I can't even get past that, like, that shield of, like, shouting and, like, waving my dick around, being like, no, I'm a big dude. Shut up. Because that's how you handle people telling you you're, like, small, right?
Yeah, totally.
Yeah.
I love it.
Yeah, so you get, it kind of splinter. It's not a whole, well, it's like a little more than a third, three-fifths of the gang. Oh, wait, that's too much. Two-fifths of the gang. Like, they don't want to, like, when Arcee's like, yeah, fuck you, and, like, goes to leave to party without Cantor, you carry three-fifths of them away, and the other two-fifths are like, yeah, man, that's, you know. Like,
we're going to have our own party with blackjack and hookers.
Cantor's cool. I'm not going to... What are you talking about?
Yeah, no.
And the gang itself doesn't have any conflict with each other. They're not like...
Right, there's not Arcee side and Cantor's side.
Not really. They just kind of pull away, and then when you look back, like, some of them are around Cantor, like miming him shooting a dude and, like,
nice. Well, and I've got two guys that are like have their shoulders underneath the armpits of Breaker as we're carrying him off. Like, it's a little, I mean, it's not that we're not going to go have fun, but it's definitely a little bit more somber. Like,
can't enjoy your funeral.
You got to go throw a dude off a dock and say whatever things you say for the dead. So yeah, I can see, like,
yeah, there's like a, maybe it's the, you like carry him like he's drunk, like arm in arm.
Yeah.
And you kind of drag his feet and you get to the thing and then say your little, the thing you say and dump him in. And meanwhile, Cantor's buying everybody like the most expensive booze and luxurying it up somewhere.
Yeah, totally.
Yeah, and it's weird. It's like all the tension is between you two.
Yeah.
And it just dissipates as soon as everyone, like, goes off.
It dissipates as soon as we're not next to each other. Like,
yeah.
Because none of us have any beef with the gang or each other or anything like that. It's just entirely with each other. In fact, I think the only beef here is really Arcee's beef with Cantor. I don't think Cantor has beef with Arcee. It's just...
No, yeah, you just keep acting like a fucking dick to me all the time. I get things done, and you're so ungrateful.
Yeah, if this gang was consisted of thinkers, you would have planted seeds, and they would be pondering these things you said. Yeah. But that's not the case.
They are drinkers. Nothing.
They're doing what they want to do. Yeah, it's all.
Yeah, like Cantor's attitude here is kind of like of like a dog. Like, you let me off the leash, and I fucking did my job, right? I scared off the intruders, and then you just started yelling at me and hitting me with a newspaper. Well, I'm like, what did I do? Why are you doing this? I did my job. Yeah, that's not fair. But instead of being like, hey, hold on, I'm really hurting inside because I'm like, no, fuck you, and I'm like getting all up in your face.
Yeah, no, that's good. Someday I would love it if Arcee and Cantor can have a nice conversation, but it just hasn't happened.
Cantor is not an easy man to have a nice conversation with.
I think it'll happen. It just can't happen in the street after a fight before you go to the bar.
Right. Well, there's a pride issue. Both of them have a lot of pride, and
that's okay. There will come a time when Oscar's like, no, this has gone too far. We're gonna talk it out.
Well, it's one of those things too, because like Cantor's like driven by fear, right? Like, he's just like gripping the edge of like his own life with his fingernails, and like only knows one way through, and like showing weakness is not gonna make it any easier for him. Yeah.
Well, the very first thing that happened in this series was Cantor went to see his friend at City Hall, and he was like, look, we want to take some turf. And she's like, the only place I know of is controlled by this bigger, tougher gang. You shouldn't do that. And he's like, that's what I'm going to do.
Yeah.
Totally. That was the very first scene of the game.
Yeah.
And that's how it is. He's not a reasonable man.
No.
So it's good. That's really good. Like I, as you know, I'm a huge fan of unreasonable characters.
Yeah.
It may doom this crew, but that's fine. Like we are not playing to keep.
We're not playing to like get to tier 5 and kill the dragon. That's not the goal of the game. I don't get my +5 Vorpal, Duskwall Slayer.
Nope. Nope. Yep.
Yeah.
But at least for tonight, despite mom and dad fighting, there's a big victory for the sixth time.
Oh yeah.
No two ways about it.
We're whole. I mean, size breaker, but we're whole and they're not.
Yep.
So maybe we can do XP and then wrap up.
Sure.
Is that good?
Yeah, absolutely.
And we'll handle downtime and stuff next time.
Yeah, I want some downtime. Mostly because I got stabbed. And
so let's start with Cantor this time because we talked about this last time.
Yeah, I was just going to ask.
I think we should drop your Lurk XP thing because it's just not who Cantor is.
Mm-hmm.
And we talked about replacing it with Cutter, which is solving problems with violence, which
that's for real what he's about.
Probably the best thing to do here. And it's something I'm thinking about in the design too, that may be a thing, like as just an option in play where you can switch out your class XP trigger, because it seems like a good idea.
If you can make it like keys, and I mean, I know you've done keys up a lot.
Yeah.
But these are keys. Yeah.
Yeah.
But you can switch out keys and you can buy off a key. And so I think leaving the Lurk with the key that they have to start with is great, but tell somebody,
Well, I picked the thing about like Lurk is that I picked a Lurk partly because your character felt more like a Cutter. Right? Like the thing about Cantor is he's not a good fighter. He just is like fast. And sucker punches people, right? Like, he's just like, I'm going to shoot this guy in the back of the head. Like, if he gets in a straight-up fight, he gets his ass kicked. But, so I wanted reflexes in Daredevil, but all the other stuff, except for maybe Ambush, are not really, like, super appropriate for the character. Like, he's more just about, he's kind of like a weird, like, face in some ways.
Right, he is a face, for sure. I mean, I think your next advances are going to be Veteran and taking moves off of other playbooks, honestly.
You got two
moves you can do that with, and that's probably your jam, as my guess.
Yeah.
So let's go ahead and say that the Cutter XP thing applies here, and read it that way. So you've already ticked off your desperate actions.
Yeah.
Addressing problems, a tough challenge with violence or threats. I think violence for sure.
Yeah.
I would say 2 XP.
Yeah, I was going to say 2.
Because it happened multiple times. Well, actually, I don't know. Is it triggered on each thing now because it's a key?
Oh yeah, actually, sorry. Yeah, there are end of session things, but then there's also per event things. So
okay, so the desperate moves is per event, right?
Yep, desperate is, and so is your playbook thing. So
okay,
I would say 3 probably on violence. I think
okay,
I think
that's what I think. Yeah.
Okay.
That makes sense.
Sure.
Then at end of session, if you've expressed your beliefs, drives, heritage, or background, yes. Mm-hmm. For sure.
Yeah.
Yep.
And also mark XP. I rewrote this slightly. If you cause a problem with your vice, ambition, or flaws.
Okay.
I think ambition or flaws, we could say here. Flaws.
Sure. Yeah. I mean, I was very intently playing Cantor as Cantor, right? Like, being like, this is a stupid thing, and I'm like just going all in on it. But
I would argue for 2 for that one, because killing the bouncer is the first one, and then the thing with RC is a different problem.
Well, killing the bouncer was last session.
That's right.
But I mean, I don't know if we did XP last. Did we do XP last? We did XP last session.
We did. Yeah.
So,
So yeah, definitely take one for flaws, because that was okay. That was really strong.
Sure.
Oh yeah.
Okay.
And just to be clear, I think we talked about this last time, but you tick XP now wherever you want, like just put it in any box.
Okay, sure. So I have 8 to throw around.
Yeah, you can put them in playbook or in attributes or wherever you want to put them.
Right.
Got it. Okay.
You have 8. Wow, nice.
Yeah.
Nice. That's a playbook advance or a...
Well, and I have some from last time too, right? Like I've got some XP marked that I didn't use. Like I didn't fill, so... Right.
Yeah, sweet.
So I have like 12 total, so...
Nice.
So
nice.
I'll spend those between sessions. But yeah, I think I'll probably take... Yeah, I want to bump up some of my other stuff, but I'll let you know between sessions what I decide to take.
That's cool.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Oscar.
Well, hello there.
desperate actions are accounted for. Addressing challenges with arcane power or knowledge. Yeah.
Did you do that? Really?
Three, I
think. Is
that
a thing you did?
Saved Ginger's life. Saved Darcy's life.
Yeah.
Dealt with Silver.
I love it. Just like nobody noticed or saw any of that too. Like save my life. The
actually,
hell you did.
It's untrue. There's like that. I mean, you saw like shit rotating. You saw lightning coming into me. You saw like ghosts forming in midair and grabbing a dude and possessing him.
Yeah. I think we saw Oscar fucking. Kicking ass. We didn't see the whisper fight up top, but he still like possessed a dude and ice spiked the dude. Yeah.
There's that awesome moment where I like broke the wind and shattered the wall behind me. And then I did my creepy Oscar going through shadows.
Well, I mean, yeah, like out of character, there's no question that all the stuff you're doing was super awesome, but I feel like Cantor would be like, yeah, okay, you did some magic stuff, whatever. Great, good work. That's your job.
Yeah.
So how many XPs?
Oh yeah, mega.
I don't know about Silver. I'm a little on the fence with that. She's as much of a problem as she was at the beginning of the session. I don't know if you.
Right. I mean, well, that was primarily resisting, but you definitely at least 3.
I'll take 3.
Sure. I'm 3.
I'll take. We're good. Silver, I'm not gonna argue too much.
You sort of brushed
her aside. I made my case. The decision is there.
All right.
It's all good. Next is at the end of session, if you've expressed your beliefs, drives, heritage, or background, what do you guys think?
Well, we, like, yes, a lot. I mean, it's just, what do we pick? Because
yeah,
I think background and heritage is huge, but beliefs are also really a part of it. But, like, what we really learned was your connection to Satara and your uncle and all that. Like, that's what was on the screen.
The rest of
it was there. It was just subtext interactions, but... I mean, can you tick that one more than once, or is that...
Yeah, you can tick that one twice.
Okay.
I'm fine with that.
The last one is, do you folks feel that I have caused problems with my vice, obsession, or ambition? And all I have to say is, so, how do you feel about my little tattoos everywhere?
Yeah, absolutely.
It's like we're all just racing to be the ones responsible for ruining everything.
Yeah.
Well, I would point out that John did give us XP for it, so.
I should say, when you give somebody XP for being toxic,
yes to that.
Yes.
Awesome. So I have 6 and they are all going straight into my playbook advancement.
Nice. More powers,
yeah.
No. We need to get to, I need to get to beyond so that the next time some schmo from a different gang is like, no, I zap you with lightning, I can just be like,
psh.
No. Not happening.
Totally.
RC.
All
right, I got my desperate actions. When I address a tough challenge with violence or threats, I believe I'm going to claim 1 for... okay, cool. that's what I was going to
do. You want to make a case for 4? Because I'm pretty sure it's at least 3.
I think it's 3.
I haven't counted up yet, but 3 sounds right to me. 3 sounds great. There was lots of violence and lots of threats.
There was, especially the commanding stuff. That was so important.
Yeah, huge deal.
Yeah.
Beliefs, drives, heritage, or background? Yes, totally. Yeah.
I think actually Cantor sort of really solidified this, is that I wasn't all about like, we're going to do it the military way, until it was like, well, it's that or we're fucking reckless savages. So I wasn't all about like, let's go be sailors again, or let's go be in the Navy again. But then it like became like, well, that's the choice. It's let's all be in the Navy and follow the rules, or let's all be fucking crazy motherfuckers. Thank you, Adam, for helping come out. Because I feel like that was a huge deal.
Yeah.
And tell me if this is grubbing, because I'm happy to relent it. That's all about her heritage and the way she thinks things are done. But there was a big, big point about not killing people and specifically sending back a message, because I don't want, because as much as her pride is probably self-destructive or destructive to the group, she doesn't want to go to war with the Red Sashes. And her goal was to secure this space rather than to make it a war zone. So I'm going to push one for drives in that she was really fighting tooth and nail to send a guy alive so that he could deliver a message.
I totally agree. I feel like this is...
You took hit.
Absolutely. Take another one for that. And that also shines a spotlight on this thing where you and Cantor are actually... Your drives are very similar. Like, we're going to run this territory. It's going to be ours. We're going to control it. It's just the methods
are so different.
Oh, like, yeah, totally.
You think you can do it by, like, establishing yourself and playing in the game with the other gangs. And Cantor is like, no, we have to just eliminate everybody who's our enemy. And,
actually, what I think is super interesting is that ultimately I think the solution is going to be both, right? Like, Arcee's going to be the one that builds us up. Cantor's going to be one that deals with the problems. And Oscar's just happy to let you guys do that.
This is the wire, right? Like, it's Stringer Bell versus Avon.
Yeah,
and,
totally.
And I think that's exactly where it is.
Yeah.
Ultimately, that's both like their strength and what tears them down at the end. So that's
you know, Sean, somebody just compared you to Idris Elba. So
that's pretty awesome. I'll take Idris Elba any day of the week. Also, Mark, have you caused a problem with your obsessions, ambitions, or faults during the session? I kind of feel like that's all that last pissing match between me and Cantor was.
Absolutely. Yep. You could have relented and been like, okay, fine, you can come with us, like, we're all together, but you're like, no. People want to come with me, come with me. Okay.
All right, awesome. I'm gonna take a playbook advance, because that just hit me to 8. And it's either gonna be not to be trifled with or leader, I'm not sure, so.
Yeah, those are both good for you, for sure, obviously.
When you make an example of someone, no, that's not at all. sweet.
Cool. I guess hang on. Let's actually
We should do our crew advancement if people have time.
I don't know that we did much on, but let's just do it real fast. Acquire product, attract customers, or covertly sell your contraband.
Fuck no.
Not tonight.
Literally just killed some people.
Yep.
Improve your product's quality, variety, or prestige? No. Bolster your crew's reputation.
You've got to have done that one.
Yeah.
I think you should take 2.
I would want 2. Yeah. Hell yeah. Because if nothing else, that whisper is going to be carrying a glowing brand other whispers.
And we did it on both. We gave them both barrels, right? Because they're going to be like, yeah, but like on the surface, they're a bunch of crazy motherfuckers who'll kill people. But then also there's other secret scary shit going on. Like, it's we got both angles.
Yeah.
Contend with challenges above your current station. Yes.
Yep. Tier 2 motherfuckers coming to our houses. Right.
Yeah.
Swordsmen.
You definitely did.
That was really cool, John. I like those dudes a lot with their fucking sash foo and their blades. I really wanted to fight one with swords, but it wasn't in the cards, man. I was just scrap. I don't think I ever swung the sword in that fight.
That was cool, actually, because like you didn't. They came in with their skills, and your gang came in with your skills, and then the whispers battled each other.
Yep.
But it was this contrasting styles.
Right, right. It was very much thuggery versus skill.
Yeah.
That's what our gang is, the fine thugs.
What's scary is Oscar actually did that too. The other guy was totally, or whatever they are, what totally did all sorts of like precision setups, ranged attacks, controls of ghosts, freeing my ghost, and I was just like, no, I'm just gonna power through it.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. You were totally brute force whisper. That's I didn't think about that.
Yeah, that's
brute force. Brute force whispers is the saxophone cover of the song from your album.
No, it's like the secret track, right?
Yeah, they're just covering your song, but with
if you listen to like track 85, 70 tracks of nothing.
Brute force whispers.
That's awesome.
I remember
heavy metal saxophone.
Remember like 60 tracks of Tool that were just like cricket noises until you finally got to them?
Yep. Little compact discs.
Yeah.
Well.
Nice. So that puts us at 3 ticks for our crew. So the crew is not advancing.
Okay.
That's fine.
But that's okay. We'll just have to be, because this was a reactive session, right? This was us like holding our shit, and then
basically, yeah. You moved up into someone's space and they fought back and you held on to what you had. So that's how it goes sometimes. Now what also will happen is the Vice Den, once it gets up and running, which we'll kind of bleed that in when we play again into the downtime.
Yeah.
It's going to start generating some more money for you guys. So you'll have a little bit more money than usual. Play around with. So that'll be cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think that's all our business.
Cool. I think so. Yeah. Until we do downtime stuff.
Good criming, folks. Good criming.
Good criming indeed.
Well crimed.
Sort of defensive criming, but there was lots of
badass defensive criming.
There was definitely.
I've been watching a lot of I don't know if you guys have seen the show yet. I've been watching Narcos on Netflix.
Oh, I haven't started it yet. I really want to watch it.
Fuck, it's good. Yeah. It's so good.
Man. I'm gonna start it after this is over. I'm gonna start it tonight.
Okay. Every time I watch an episode of it, I think of like Blades. And I think of the board game Andy and Abyss and how I want to play both and just be like a badass criminal, because it is hella good. Yeah. It's a sweet show.
Man, when he's talking about burying money, oh.
Yeah. Well, like the it's cool because the show, and I mentioned this on an earlier show, they don't shy away from subtitles in that, because they're like, it's set in Colombia, so everybody's just going to speak Spanish and we're just going to subtitle that shit and then away we go. And it's...
Yep.
Yeah, it's very cool.
That's really good. I was hoping that was the case.
When I watched the first episode, I was worried. I was like, oh, are they just going to like make them speak English with Spanish accents? But nope, Spanish all the way through. It's very cool.
That's cool.
Yeah, they have a Brazilian actor actually playing the
Escobar,
main narco. Yeah, he's really good too.
That guy's great. I love that actor. He's awesome.
Yeah. You know what is hilarious? I just realized the playbook move that we have for our crew is silver tongues.
Yeah.
I'm going to be pushing for lookouts, but I think we need training so that we have some options in downtime.
Yeah. No, I just thought it was fucking hilarious. Looking at that.
There's the Italians, speaking of Narcos, Marco and some of the other Italian story gamers they're doing a playset for Blades. That's the Italian, the Year of Lead. Or the Years of Lead, rather. It's the like crime. It's the Italian version of the Colombian drug war, basically. Nice. And that's the playset. Oh man, that and the Western one are like, they're all cool, but those two I really want to play.
There's definitely some space for a like mid to late 80s like Colombia, Panama, like you could play this game there so easy.
Yeah,
it would be. It's such a perfect fit, but I wonder how much I could take it. Like, the fantasy angle makes everything kind of fun, and I wonder if playing in the real world would just be like,
there are people that love that about like role playing games that are just like, it's so miserable.
Well, that's true.
So miserable and Jason real. Moiser. Yeah, Jason Moiser. Yeah, I mean it's a genre that's really popular right now, right? Like this game could do like Peaky Blinders really easily, and like basically any kind of like turf war-y, like
do Sons of Anarchy.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
Oh yeah, totally. Yeah.
Yeah. With much better acting.
I'm happier to be compared to Idris Elba than Ron Perlman.
Fair, definitely fair.
All right, awesome. Well, let's roll out and we'll do schedule foo to make this happen again, because clearly we need to find out.
This I feel like we started out with like, oh, this is fun, we'll do it every now and then, and now we're getting momentum.
This is serious, some shit going on, internal, external, everywhere.
Cool. Well, yeah, we'll take it offline and we'll figure out a day to play again, and thanks for coming, everybody.
Thanks for watching.
I'll get the videos over to you, John, probably in the next couple of days. You can get them up on YouTube if anybody missed the beginning of the episode, and stick around, keep an eye out on my schedule for more future Blades shenanigans.
Yeah.
Thanks for coming, everybody. See you next time.
Bye.